Hai, selamat datang ke rancangan WTT Walk the Talk. Dalam program ini kita akan menampilkan tokoh muzik yang telah banyak jasa dalam membangunkan industri muzik negara. Dalam episod pertama ni kita kenalkan Cik Jeffrey Yong Luthier, seorang pembuat alat muzik bertali yang bukan sahaja terkenal di sini malah namanya terkenal di peringkat antarabangsa. Cik Jeffrey Yong. Terima kasih Jeffrey Yong kerana bersama kami pagi hari. So kita untuk episod pertama ni elok juga Encik Jeffrey terangkan sedikit pengalaman dalam pembuatan alat muzik.
Oh, I've been doing this for 30 years and you know, starting from a small one or two hand tools. So this is my dream and then finally it come true. And it's actually my hobby and I like music and guitar is my main instruments. So from playing, from teaching how to play the guitar, so I finally ended making the guitar.
So kalau tengok sekeliling ni, apa yang mempengaruhi JFP hingga dapatkan buat
this bank? This environment is like you know, where you get the nature around you and it's quiet with the fresh air and yeah, it's a very the best environment, you know, okay, for inspiration.
Okay. Saya diwahamkan banyak gitar yang Cik Jeffrey buat adalah daripada kayu-kayu tempatan. Yeah. Bolehkah Cik Jeffrey nyatakan kayu-kayu tempatan yang mana, jenis apa yang selalu mudah didapat di Malaysia ni?
See, Malaysia is in the tropical zone, right? So we have plenty of trees. And many years ago when I was in America, I wanted to buy wood to make guitar, and the guy who sell wood, he said, "Oh Jeff, you are from Malaysia. Why do you need to buy your own wood from America?" You know. So I was like, "Oh, really?" So after that, I came back and I do research, and I find that there are so many wood which are not only beautiful, but there are a lot of wood that are wasted. Like those along the roadside, you know, those rain tree and those a lot of fruit trees, they are chopped and then they're disposed. And after the tree, after growing for so many years, some hundred or more, and they just cut it down and throw away. Mm. It's a waste, right? And a lot of this wood, the beauty of the wood and also the quality of the wood. So I experiment with this wood to try to make guitars, because guitars is a very traditional Western instrument, and a lot of the material they use from there, you know, and of course some of the like rosewood they import from the tropical forest. Yeah. And so when I came back, I start experiment and do research on the wood, and I found that there are a lot of wood which are suitable to make instruments. So that's how it started. And yeah, from the years, and you know, of course, you don't just simply follow. So you need to start your own experiment, you know, and it works.
Itu hakikatnya tentang yang kita tahu bahawa banyaklah kayu-kayu tempatan atau kita panggil sebagai kayu eksotik di Malaysia ni yang boleh digunakan untuk dalam pembuatan alat muzik. Dan ada kalanya kita tanya pada secara umumnya pada orang ramai bila kita kata kayu-kayu pembuatan ni datangnya dari Malaysia. Jadi mungkin orang akan tanya, bolehkah? Tak boleh ke lagu?
Yeah, I mean still until today after 30 years, right? People still say, oh, boleh ke? Yeah, because you see a lot of this information, right? They are written years ago and by people not from here, see, from the West or from European country, and then From there, they of course, from their view, they always look things from the side. And most of them, they don't even travel out of the country. They don't even know where is Malaysia.
Yeah.
You know, and like I said earlier, in Malaysia, we are living in a jungle. We have so many natural resources, natural wood. And of course, I'm specializing in wood that are not from the jungle, that people used to cut and throw away, right? These are like recycled. So a lot of my wood that I use are from the trees they cut from the roadside or from the garden, you know, or people who are from the plantation where people develop the area, so they need to cut down those old trees. So that's what I use. I don't use those trees that you chop from the jungle, because that again is you know, helping the environment, right?
Sekarang menarik, banyak fakta yang kita dah ketahui sini, dan kita ada banyak benda yang kita akan tahu kejap lagi. Jadi untuk itu, jom kita tengok apa kayu-kayu yang telah disediakan yang dia telah potong dan dikeringkan oleh Cik Effie Yong. Jom.
Okay, let's go.
Selamat kembali ke rancangan WTT. Di belakang saya ini, kita lihat berapa keping kayu yang telah dipotong dan telah melalui proses pengeringan. Dan kayu-kayu ini digunakan untuk dalam pembuatan alat muzik gitar. Dan untuk itu, Cik Jeffrey Yong, mungkin Cik Jeffrey Yong boleh kenalkan ke jenis-jenis kayu yang digunakan dalam proses pembuatan alat muzik gitar.
Okay, here are just some of the wood I have, and of course, we have also those log. You have to process first, and that takes a lot of time too. You know, so these are some of the already pre-cut size wood, and from this, you're going to cut in the smaller size to make the instruments. Okay, here are some wood that I use for my guitars. Okay, for example, this one, this is made from mango tree. You know, some people they think the mango is different from different country, but this is local mango, the fruit that we eat, okay, mango tree. Yeah. So this another model, also mango. Okay. And I'm the only one who use all the same wood for one guitar. See, a lot of traditional guitars, they said different part of the guitar they have to use different wood, right? So this one is called mempisang, or translated as banana wood, right? Banana wood. The grain is so beautiful. And this is the rain tree, also known as monkey pot, right? So they have very beautiful grain. And this one is the Malaysian blackwood. Malaysian blackwood actually was named by me, you know, because this one commercially is called kayu malam. So in translation, you cannot call it nightwood. It sounds very funny. So I call it Malaysian blackwood. So it's one of the best wood in the world for guitar making. Now this is a very special guitar, and this using wood from this is rengas wood, all right. And also because some of the wood are beautiful, but they are not so workable. That means they cannot bend, especially the side, so it breaks. So I kind of join them together in pieces and make a guitar with this, right? So again, this is against the conventional way of instrument making, but later I'll show you how it sounds like. So the most important thing is the instruments must be good sounding. It doesn't matter how you make it or what material you use, right?
Sekarang kita berada dalam bilik yang digunakan khas untuk pembuatan alat gitar, dan tuan-tuan tahu selalu kita dengar pokok rambai. pokok rambai ni buah dia masam. Dan kita tahu hanya buah dia saja. Sebenarnya pokok rambai, kayu dia juga boleh digunakan untuk pembuatan alat muzik gitar. Ini adalah contoh gitar yang dibuat daripada pokok rambai. So, mungkin Cik Jeffrey boleh cerangkan dengan lebih dalam lagi.
Okay, this is a very interesting wood, and this is the first guitar in the world made from this wood. And look at the grain, they're so beautiful. The top is a traditional wood, spruce, but the back and side, it's from this pokok rambai, right? All right, see the grain. So actually, all this grain, they are available only in those trees that have fruits, they bear fruits, because each season, when they have fruits, the plant will need different minerals. So they create a kind of figure.
Jadi untuk kayu ni, berapa umur pokok rambai sebaiknya untuk di?
This one maybe about at least 60 years to 100 years. The older the tree, the more grain they have.
You know? 60 tahun, 60 tahun makan buah rambai, tak tahu ada pokok rambai itu kayu dia boleh buat gitar. Yeah. Menarik. Jadi ada kayu seterusnya. Ini ada Cik Jafri tunjukkan okay. Kayu seterusnya.
Okay, this one is from the rambutan tree.
Pokok rambutan.
Alright. Of course, many people, especially in the city, they don't see a big rambutan tree. Their trees are very small. But in the old kampung, they have big rambutan tree which are grown from the seeds. You know. So I see the grains again. They're very, very. This is a very at least 100 years old. Free, you know. Right. So next. So this is my invention. See, there are two different tone color, right? The back and the sides. And the front. So this part is from made from mango wood. Okay, and this part is from the rain tree, right, or the monkey pot. So actually, the combination, why? It's not just for the look, because each type of wood, they have different density, right? And the lower part, this which is the treble part here, I use a softer wood because it give a sweeter treble. And this part, I use the rain tree because it's very good for bass. You know, so the back is the same, right? Of course, these are to enhance the value, you know, to add more. Right. So this special guitar have two different wood combination.
Ini satu sangat menarik. Kita lihat bagaimana dua jenis kayu boleh dicantumkan dan dibentuk demikian sehingga memberi satu kontras pada bentuk secara fizikal gitar ini. Jadi ini merupakan satu produk yang sangat menarik dan ini boleh adalah sangat berbeza dan istimewa. Dan apa yang penting sekali di sini ialah produk ini dibuat dari hasil kayu tempatan. Seperti yang Cik Jeffrey katakan tadi, ada produk daripada kayu pokok rambai, pokok rambutan, ada pokok durian dan ini ada pokok monkey pot dan seterusnya. Dan ini satu produk yang patut kita rasa bangga. Dan ini adalah satu inovasi yang telah dijalankan oleh Cik Jeffrey Yong. Bila dengar macam ini nak menyanyi pula. Kita tak nyanyilah. Dan nanti orang tak tengok pula.
So this, when I make the top and I keep it here. Because this room, you notice is very comfortable. Huh?
Yeah.
It's very, it's dry.
Betul.
So
betul.
You need to dry, keep it in a dry
area. Jadi di sini kita lihat juga apa yang digantung di sini adalah semua kayu-kayu yang dah siap dibuat dan bila ini sesuai dengan suhu yang dijaga dan kita akan lihat sini bagaimana proses-proses pembuatan alat gitar ini dibuat dan kalau rata-rata kita ni kita rasa sesuatu yang sangat menarik di dalam satu dunia gitar yang kita terkejut bila mendapati bahawa kayu alat-alat muzik ni dibuat daripada kayu-kayu tempatan yang selama ni tak terfikir pun ya. Kita tengoklah bagaimana menarik dan bagaimana inovasinya kreatif yang Cik Jeffrey yang menggunakan kayu-kayu eksotik di Malaysia dalam pembuatan alat muzik gitar. Kita kembali lagi selepas ini.
Hai geng, hari ini Adam nak beritahu bahagian inovasi jaringan strategi dan pemasaran BIGSP Aswara akan mengadakan slot pembelajaran dari pelbagai bidang berdurasi 60 saat. Antaranya berkenaan percetakan, teknik bermain muzik, teknik nyanyian, teknik suntingan gambar dan banyak lagi. Ha, menarik kan? Jadi nantikan video-video berkenaan di Facebook rasmi Aswara ya geng. Untuk makluman, video-video ini juga akan disiarkan semula di Facebook, Instagram, TikTok dan YouTube BIGSP Aswara. Jadi siapa yang belum follow BIGSP Aswara, jom follow sekarang. Eh, lupa pula, video itu semua akan dimuat naik setiap hari tau geng, jam 8 malam. Dan jangan lupa untuk saksikan 60 Second Education. Follow, jangan tak follow.
Selamat kembali ke WTT Walk the Talk bersama Cik Jeffrey Yong, pakar dalam pembuatan alat muzik gitar. Cik Jeffrey Yong, kita dah dengar tadi tentang kayu-kayu tempatan yang digunakan untuk pembuatan gitar. Dan kita juga sedari bahawa ramai juga di kalangan pelajar-pelajar yang hanya berminat bermain gitar. Tapi dia mungkin boleh fikirkan satu option lain di mana bukan sekadar bermain gitar tetapi dalam pembuatan alat gitar. Jadi pada pandangan Cik Jeffrey, bagaimana ni kita boleh galakkan pelajar-pelajar kita, mungkin orang ramai di luar yang berminat dalam pembuatan alat muzik gitar ni?
Yeah, well, many people think making guitar is impossible. This is sebab ini this is imported. So they thought only certain people or certain country that make an instrument. This is global. You can do it anyway. So I've already proven, you know, not only building the instrument but using 99% of the local material. So, and it's also a very lucrative hobby, you know. With, of course, if you are very good, then you can sell your instruments at a good price. And it's basically talking about the interest and the skill. So these two things, which people think they don't have, but actually you can learn. You know, we have courses to teach you how to build guitars. Last time is different. You had to go to all the way to America to learn how to make instrument. So now it's right here, and it's not just making a normal standard guitar, but a world quality instrument. You know? So it's good. The local, students, right? If they like the instrument, especially guitars, you don't just play the guitar. You can, because you, if you want to be a good player, you have to practice a lot and you have to be very talented. And you notice on the stage, there's only one or two guitarists. You cannot have 50 guitarists on the stage, right? But instruments, you can do it at home. You don't have to have a big factory, you know. So, and this is a kind of a hobby, and then you can make your income from this. You know.
Ini sangat menarik, satu menarik. Satu perkara lagi yang mungkin dilihat. Kecenderungan kita ramai yang beli gitar mengikut pada jenama-jenama yang diimport dari luar negara, sedangkan kita tahu ada juga produk yang dibuat secara tempatan. Jadi pada pandangan Cik Jeffrey, bagaimana Cik Jeffrey melihat siri perbandingan kualiti di antara produk Cik Jeffrey dengan produk gitar yang jenama dari luar negara?
Okay, to have the comparison, okay, I don't compare here. The best thing is if your instrument can be sold in their country, it's a real proof, right? That, let's say America, if my guitar can sell in America, well, there's nothing to compare here. You know, because of course every people like to buy things imported. You know, if you are very, but not necessarily the local quality is no good. You know, it can be better.
Okay. Sekarang lagi perkara yang menarik untuk kita lihat di sini, dalam masa proses pembuatan gitar, saya rasa mungkin ramai yang datang bertanya Jeffrey untuk belajar bermain membuat gitar ni. Mungkin ada pelajar-pelajar dari luar negara yang datang untuk jumpa Jeffrey. Kalau Jeffrey ada pelajar luar negara, berapa ramai? Mereka ni dari negara mana?
Okay, it's very good and bad, you know. Good in the sense that I have about 90% of my students are coming from all over the world. and a lot of them are luthiers, you know, because they find interesting because the approach and the material they use are different from the conventional material. And the sad thing is, very, very few local, you know, wanted to learn this because they think it's either impossible or either it's too low quality, especially people. A lot of people they say, oh, you use mango wood to make guitar or durian wood, any sound. So this is, I mean, I heard the same you know, question many times, but you can try the instrument. It proves by itself, right? You don't have to talk a lot. But a lot of people they look at it's not a racist comment, but they say a certain type of people or white people make better instrument. No, it's not true. Hmm. You know?
Jadi ini ada kaitan dengan persepsi tentang barang-barang tempatan dilihat sebagai tidak berkualiti, sedangkan Cik Jeffrey telah buktikan bahawa kayu-kayu ini di kualiti yang tinggi dan diterima di peringkat antarabangsa, dan juga kayu ini telah diperkenalkan di dalam konvensyen-konvensyen luthier antarabangsa. Dan menurut pandangan Cik Jeffrey yang telah menghadiri banyak seminar atau konvensyen antarabangsa, khususnya luthier convention, bagaimana pembuat gitar luar negara melihat kayu Malaysia?
See, this the traditional, everybody start from traditional way. So traditional way have not many choice, right? And of course, that material used for guitar, they either use spruce or mahogany or rosewood. You just name a few, but these are like local wood, like mango or rain tree or durian tree. So these are called alternative wood. And you see, I mean, the industry has been for so many years, and especially in the instrument industry, they always look for the best wood. How many best wood can you get? You know, and of course, the wood are getting less, right? And there are more and more builders, more and more factories, and it's very sad. A lot of good material has been used for just commercialized instruments, just because of the brand or name, but the quality, especially the sound, you need a very skilled person to convert or to build a guitar with a good sound. Not just the material. The material doesn't matter. But in terms of marketing, people always look at the material. They thought, oh, this is a premium or master grade wood. Oh, it should be good. Not necessary.
Okay.
That's why I personally feel there's it's very sad. Many of the good wood has been taken up to make instruments just to sell. But the quality is nothing special.
Okeylah, kita berhenti seketika dan kita akan kembali lagi selepas ini.
Okay, this is a very special guitar I've made, and this is made up of many pieces of scrap wood. And this guitar is almost finished at a kind of a final sanding stage. And John is going to demo how to fine sand before this sent to spraying. You have to first look up with the paws, you know.
Right?
Okay. And the feeler. Yeah. And the feel with your hand, the rough edge. Yeah? Mm. Yeah, see, there's a spot here. Just lightly, because you have to level. Yeah. Yeah, this part, this spot also. This spot also. Yeah. So at this stage, you can't really see, but you have to feel by your hand, yeah. Right, that's the best. Now you don't use a lot of strength, just fine, very lightly sand. Just it's already, this is a third coat of feeler. Yeah. Okay, good. Yeah, good. Yeah, very good.
Akademi Seni Budaya dan Warisan Kebangsaan Aswara merupakan institusi pengajian tinggi yang menyediakan ruang pembelajaran, penyelidikan dan penerbitan.
Selamat kembali ke rancangan WTT. Tadi kita telah mendengar temubual di antara Encik Jeffrey Yong dan Encik John. Dan seterusnya, Encik Jeffrey, dah berapa lama berkecimpung dalam bidang ni, mungkin ada satu pengharapan yang tinggi. Dan bagaimana Encik Jeffrey melihat tentang perkembangan pembuatan alat muzik yang Encik Jeffrey cuburi selama ini?
Okay, yeah. After so many years of experimenting with so many different material, and I really open a lot of opportunity, you know, because this is a traditional instrument, and many people still using the traditional way of making the instruments, and also the traditional material. Mm-hmm. So I mean, as we all know, material is a very important thing, and it's getting less and less, you know. And of course, I'm opening up a very big opportunity for people to experiment, you know, to use instrument, making use of alternative wood.
Yes.
Right. So I hope the future generation, right, can be more adaptive and also innovative, right, in using material like this to build better instruments.
Yes. Jadi kalau demikian, apa harapan Cik Jeffrey untuk masa akan datang pada mereka yang berminat dalam pembuatan alat muzik ini? Dan Cik Jeffrey, bagaimana Cik Jeffrey melihat sejauh mana industri pembuatan alat muzik ini boleh pergi ke peringkat antarabangsa?
Well, I already you know, kind of showed a way right into the international standard, the market, and I hope our local students, right, follow up or pick up this hobby and career, right, and because we have plenty of material in the first place, so we don't have to buy. So when we save a lot of money, right? Okay. And of course, this material that I use are very high quality material, and they can be made into high quality instruments. So my hope is the future students can learn, can take up this trade. So, and of course, to reach the international standard, is there's no limit, there's no border, as long as you have the confidence, you know. And I've already proven, right, that we have a lot of material that we can use for making guitars.
Selamat maju jaya dan selamat mencapai apa hasrat Encik Jeffrey bagi antarabangsa. Okey, kita telah mendengar dan buat wawancara dengan Cik Jeffrey Yong dan juga Cik John tentang pembuatan alat muzik gitar ini. Dan sayang ni kita dah sampai penghujung rancangan. Dan kita akan jumpa balik dalam rancangan episod yang seterusnya. Tapi untuk episod seterusnya, saya nak bagi hint sikit. Tokoh yang kita nak bawa minggu depan adalah tokoh yang berkaitan dengan muzik. Dia rancangkan muzik, dia bentukkan muzik supaya bila kita dengar sangat enak. Siapa mereka? Kita tunggu minggu depan. So, jumpa lagi dalam rancangan seterusnya WTT Walk the Talk. Bye.